President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. appoints controversial lawyer Larry Gadon as his advisor for poverty alleviation. Gadon will advise Marcos on strategies and policies aimed at combating poverty and improving the lives of the most vulnerable sectors of society. He's also tasked to work closely with government agencies, non-government groups, and other stakeholders to design anti-poverty programs. Gadon was suspended by the Supreme Court in January 2022 for verbally assaulting journalist Raisa Robles in 2021. He unsuccessfully ran for senator in 2022 under the slate of Marcos. Meanwhile, for economic think tank Ibon Foundation, Gadon's appointment reflects the Marcos administration's lack of sincerity in addressing poverty in the country.
The basic thing is some kind of empathy for the poor. And beyond that, technical skills, of course, a sense of how the economy runs and how the government can actually help and has the responsibility to alleviate poverty. None of which, I'm afraid, we don't see it at all in Larry Gadon's background. If anything, he has shown an antipathy, antagonism to activists, to civil society organizations that push for anti-poverty policies. In terms of poverty, which is supposed to be a headline issue for the administration, to choose someone like Larry Gadon to be the presidential advisor on poverty alleviation, the optics are really off. There are so many much more qualified people around. To have chosen Larry Gadon, I think, speaks very, very badly of the priorities of the administration.
Former Defense Department officer in charge Carlito Galvez Jr. returns as President Marcos's peace advisor. Galvez, a retired Philippine Army general, held the same position during the Duterte administration. He also served in other key government positions, including the Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vaccine SAR, and head of the National Task Force Against COVID-19. The latest development comes weeks after Marcos picked former lawmaker Gilbert Teodoro Jr. as the Secretary of the National Defense Department, which Galvez headed since January. Several Philippine senators once again dismiss alleged plots to unseat Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. Senator Robin Padilla says he is satisfied with the current management in the upper chamber. Zubiri also earned a praise from Senator Bongo, who describes his leadership as energetic and consultative. Senator J.V. Hercito, meanwhile, believes no one will attempt to wrest the Senate leadership since the position will be too big to fill. Senator Jingoy Estrada, who was tagged as Zubiri's supposed replacement, also firmly denies the allegation.
I do not know where that came from. Pati nga ako nadadamay dyan. Walang ganon. Walang ganun na usapan na magkakaroon ng kudeta rito sa Senado. Majority, the super majority, the members of the majority are fully supportive of Senate President Mig Zubiri. May mga chismis, may mga nagmamarites sa akin na ako raw ang papalit. Wala raw katotohanan yan.
Pero okay.
Pati ako nagugulat ako sa mga ganun klaseng chismis.
As for Zubiri, he says he serves at the pleasure of his colleagues. A similar rumor about Zubiri swirled earlier this year after the palace allegedly grew dissatisfied with the Senate's low output. The Philippine poll body is set to decide on a proposal to postpone the village and youth council elections in Negros Oriental by August. This comes after 9 Negros Oriental mayors on Sunday released a manifesto expressing support for the postponement of the polls amid a culture of fear in the province following the killing of Governor Ruel Degamo. COMELEC spokesperson John Rex Lodianco, however, notes if ever the poll body decides for postponement, the elections should be held within 30 days of October 30, which is the original date for the vote.
Yung kapangyarihan po kasi ng COMELEC para mag-postpone ng halalan ay pumapasok lamang sa election period. So makakaasa po kayo na pagtungtong ng election period po ay may desisyon na po ang COMELEC dito unless meron pong magaganap po ano, na pangyayari bago makatapos po yung aming hearing.
The fishing ban in 2 more towns in oil spill hit Oriental Mindoro province now lifted. Governor Merlito Dolor says the fisher folk in Wuhan and in Pinamalayan cannot resume their activities. He cites a study by the Science and Technology Department showing the level of oil and grease in their waters are now at an acceptable threshold. But the fishing ban in the town of Pola stays. Dolor says there's been an increase in the level of oil and grease in the waters of Pola. The Fisheries Bureau is set to conduct another study in the area in the coming weeks. Over 1,000 alleged victims of human trafficking rescued by the Philippine National Police in Las Piñas City. The PNP anti-cyber crime group said several police units raided 7 buildings earlier today after it filed a warrant to search, seize, and examine computer data. Initial police investigation shows the victims, who hail from Asian countries including Singapore, China, and Malaysia, were recruited to work in an online casino. But the police suspected it may only be a cover-up, prompting them to further inspect possible cases of investment, crypto, and love scams. Authorities will also investigate if this case is linked with Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs.
For now, ang initial is human trafficking. Pare-pareho sinabi, yung Malaysian and yung mga nakausap ko, Malaysian, Chinese also, is sa Facebook, merong job posting. So yung job posting na yun, nire-recruit sila to work dito as yung mga nag-a-assist yata. So nag-a-assist sila ng sa online gaming. Yung iba, sinasabi nila is, okay naman daw, libre naman daw ang food nila. They are working, except they are working 12 hours. So from 12 p.m. to 12 a.m. Yung iba nakausap ko, hindi allowed to go out. Pero yung iba namang nakausap ko, allowed to go out. So yan yung mga tinitignan natin.
No decision yet on whether the Philippine government will host Afghan nationals as they undergo visa processing for the United States. Defense Secretary Gilbert Yudoro says the government is still assessing if there is legal basis to grant the request of the U.S. The U.S. has asked President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to allow Afghans who work for American posts in Afghanistan to temporarily stay in the country to escape possible persecution from the Taliban. The defense chief adds they are also studying if the Philippines has enough resources to accommodate the refugees.
Bagamat gusto natin tumulong, eh may mga kababayan din tayo dito na nangangailangan din ng tulong, pabahay at pangangalaga. Yan ang balanse na kailangan harapin ng gobyerno kung humanitarian naman.
Filipino death row convict Mary Jane Veloso reunited with her family in Indonesia after 5 years. Migrante International says Veloso's parents and 2 sons traveled to Yogyakarta early last week to visit Mary Jane at her detention in Wonosari. They were able to visit her for 2 days. Now the group again calls on President Marcos to seek for Veloso's clemency.
Our call continues to be appeal for clemency, no? As Mary Jane is a victim of human trafficking. She is not a criminal. And does not belong to any drug syndicate. So that continues to be our stand, and that should be what the president should assert, no, and proactively persist in appealing to the Indonesian president for clemency for Mary Jane.
More needed to be done, no? So sana yung government would exert all its efforts or all the necessary efforts under its power to ensure na makauwi talaga si Mary Jane safely dito sa Pilipinas at sa kanyang pamilya.
In October 2010, an Indonesian court sentenced Veloso to death by firing squad for drug smuggling. She was supposed to be executed on April 29, 2015, but a last-minute reprieve spared her following the surrender of her recruiters. The Philippine government rakes in nearly 1.59 trillion pesos in revenues in the first 5 months of 2023. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno says that's nearly 11% higher than the 1.44 trillion pesos recorded during the same period last year. Diokno attributed this to higher tax collection efforts and the government's move to go after syndicates selling original receipts to buyers hoping to illegally reduce their tax liabilities. The Internal Revenue Bureau last week filed cases against those involved in such crimes after it found out that fake receipts robbed the government of nearly 18 billion pesos in tax revenues. The Philippine debt service bill up year on year in April. Data from the Treasury Bureau showed the April 2023 debt service bill surged by 376.47% to 204.8 billion pesos. A year ago, the debt service bill was almost 43 billion pesos. Month-on-month debt service payment rose by 44% in March. The agency attributes the increase now to higher amortization and interest rates payments of total debt service bill in April. 77% went to amortization, while the rest went to interest payments. A private firm offers a free review program for nursing graduates to help fill thousands of vacancies in government hospitals. More from Willard Cheng.
A review center chain is offering a free review program for nursing graduates currently working in public and private hospitals and hoping to pass the next board exams in November. 10,000 slots will be opened nationwide with the help of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Quezon City.
We are giving full review to all nurses who graduated but are not yet passers, be in government or private sector, basta't employed sila. Bakit sila yung priority namin? Kasi nandun na sila. They're already there and they are just waiting for their chance to pass.
Health Secretary Teodoro Herbosa supports the move, which aims to help fill up more than 4,000 nursing vacancies in government hospitals.
Ilan yung bakante ko? 4,500. Kung napapasa ni Carl yung 90% nun, may nurses na kagad akong. So imagine the supply side na change. Talagang meron kaagad akong nurses to put in government.
Herbosa also plans to form a National Nursing Advisory Council and appoint a chief nursing officer with the rank of undersecretary. The council will be composed of representatives from the public and private sector and is expected to tackle issues facing the nursing profession, including migration.
We'll get the heads of the Philippine Nurses Association, the Philippine Board of Nursing, the head of ANSAP, and the private and the public nurses, so that we can make them address na all these issues, not only the exam, but also yung sinasabi niya, life-work balance, other reasons to motivate them to stay and fight the brain drain of Filipino nurses.
The Philippine Nurses Association welcomes the plan, hoping that it will give voice to the profession and shine a light on issues such as wages, working condition, nurse migration, and job security.
Sana hindi hanggang doon lang, kundi syempre ang kagaya ng nasabi namin sa nakaraang weeks na ang gusto namin ay yung konkretong hakbang at aksyon na dahil napakatagal na itong mga problema at usapin ng mga nurses.
The group Filipino Nurses United is hoping it will also be given a voice. FNU calls for long-term solutions to long-standing problems such as low wages and lack of job security. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.